Hey, it's Mia and welcome to another video. I'm finally doing the video on learning Japanese. I have a lot to say, but I want to give you the most important information first for sure. So if you are thinking of like ever going to Japan, like for living and working, more than just visiting, even though like for visiting you should learn like basic sentences, like where is the toilet, how I get to the train station, stuff like that, a table for two or three, like you should learn like travel sentences. But even in case you don't have time or something, that's totally doable. It's just English and just using your Google Translate on your phone, I'm pretty sure you would survive, because I know people who went to Japan and they don't know Japanese and they were fine with just their phones and English. But anyways, if you're thinking of staying for a long time or living or working, whatever it is, and you want to learn Japanese, trust me, it's going to make all the difference. Also, you will need, if you fill a paper for anything, like, you may need to write down your name in Japanese. So yes, you should learn Japanese. To live in Japan and work, actually, you need like specific exams. So you need to prove you are like N1. So that's like the proficiency, I think that's the word. And you can have like N2 and N3 for some things, so that's like the mid level. Don't need to have the highest level for all the jobs, but it's often asked, you know, or the highest level or the mid levels. And yeah, how can you do those exams? I'll put the link in the description. Pretty much you can actually look for these, and your country should have at least one or more places where you can take this exam, and this exam happens once or twice per year. So yeah, for example, in my case, there's no place to take this exam in my country, but not in my city, so kind of sucks. But yeah, you can check what place, what organization is doing this exam. In my case, is a university in the city of Porto. They are doing like this exam, and you can see how much it costs and how you can sign up for the exam. And it's going to happen in a specific date, so you can plan your life around it. You can start maybe for doing like the easiest level, I don't know, or you can just skip the easiest levels and just try to study for a longer time and then later go and try to apply for a higher level. Some people do that instead. I do think, like, in a way, I do think, like, as long as you know Japanese, you shouldn't have to, like, prove it with an exam. Again, if you really have to, sure, you can do this exam. But I feel like if you could just speak immediately with a person, shouldn't they believe that you know Japanese? If you can, like, write basic stuff and... Well, okay, write some stuff and speak, like, literally speak with a native, communicate with a native. It's kind of shitty that they may still ask you for this exam just because you're a foreigner, even if you clearly can speak. I think Japan would be that kind of country, you know, a lot of people on YouTube who live in Japan have ran into all sorts of troubles, and a lot of people do emphasize that, like, to live and work in Japan, you need to have higher education, it's good to also have the proficiency exam, or at least know some Japanese and have some level of Japanese exam certification, even if it's not N1. Yeah, there's all these requirements. Japan is crazy, like, restrictive when it comes to this, like, working there. I hope that, like, in the future this changes and gets better, so, like, when my time comes, things are better, because I guess I would like to one day go there at least for a longer holiday, or like work there, live there, see how it is. Again, I would do the holiday thing first, because I know a lot of people actually relate to these, like, a lot of people like to go to Japan on holidays, but they would never like to work there and live there. And I feel like that may be me as well, because when I look at the crazy working hours and all that, and the crazy field transportation, like the crazy metros, like, go totally insanely filled with people, there's those people who push you into the train. Oh my god, I don't want to go through any of that. That's why, like, I hate where I live, specifically where these places where I've worked before, because I had to go into these super cramped public transportations. And that's why I like try to change for a scooter or car and not go in public transports, because I'm also very unhealthy when it comes to like breathing issues. I'm very sensitive, my immune system is just not there, it's just not that high. I was born with these like asthma and allergies, and I'm always like as if I was with a cold like the entire year, and sometimes I get worse. It's like I have a pneumonia that never got healed. I think in English it's pneumonia. I don't know how to say this in English. Anyways, I'm going to talk about learning Japanese. Sorry for the delay of these first 5 minutes. Anyways, so yeah, you need to learn Japanese. So I'm doing Skype lessons actually. Last year I was in Cambridge doing French, and that was way more expensive. Oh my god, was I recording? Okay, I got scared there. I thought I wasn't recording because this light was out. But anyways, so yeah, I got Skype lessons. I found a teacher in my area, so you may try to do this as well, because I checked online first. Online is crazy expensive for some reason, like really crazy, like thousands and thousands of dollars. I don't have that money. But I looked locally, try in my specific zone where I live now, because I'm living in a place that's a bit further away from the center and from everything. That's why it's a cheaper place to live. But it's further away, and I live in a place where there's nothing. This is a place where people just sleep. There's like no Starbucks, no anything. And there was no Japanese school, of course. But yeah, I found one that for now they are doing remote because of you know what, and it's Skype, it's over Skype, and it's only $40 a month actually. So I totally wanna do this and have an entire year of learning Japanese. I'll share with my knowledge with you as I go. So one of the first things we learn in the Japanese Skype lessons, which I'm gonna go through these and then I'll give you materials later on in the video. But one thing the first thing I learned in the Japanese lessons was the Jikoshokai. Jikoshokai is the introductions. So if you go to Japan or whatever, you may want to introduce yourself when they ask you like who you are or something. When they ask you something, I don't know. or when someone introduces themselves to you, I think you should also introduce yourself back. So it goes like this: Hajimemashite, which is like nice to meet you, kind of. Watashi wa Ana desu. Watashi wa Miya desu. But anyways, it's just saying your name and this. Watashi wa name desu. And then you can go Nihongo de shukai shimasu. In this case, it's like what was this actually? I don't remember. I know I wanted to say that I was learning Japanese or I had Japanese lessons. But you don't need to say this. This was an extra that I was trying to say, but I don't know if it's entirely correct. Okay, I can't even find this video is already not going so well. I will introduce it in Japanese. Ah, this is just me saying that I'm going to start doing my introductions in Japanese when I'm already doing them in Japanese. I'm stupid, am I? Am I not? Okay, so I was trying to say that I have Japanese classes. I don't think this is correct. Okay, I didn't learn this part in the class. I tried to like make an introduction of my own, but it's not that great. Nihongo no shugyu ga arimasu. That kind of means there's a Japanese class. Shuni nikai. So that's twice a week. Okay, this part I invented. Okay, so you can just ignore this if you want. But I wanted to like put a little bit more of myself, you know. Anyways, Poruto garu kara kimashita. So you use the name of your country and then kara kimashita. That's where you came from. Then watashi wa programa desu. It's like I am profession desu. Watashi wa aha kokugo to shite Portugal go to ego owanashi. I wanted to say with this sentence, I don't know if it's correct, the ones that I've explained like and are simple and short are like I learned in the class and they are correct. This one was like I wanted to say that I know Portuguese and English, like I speak Portuguese and English. Anyways, and in the end, dozo yoroshiku ne. I'm going to do like the correct, a short retell of the introduction of the correct sentences only that I learned in the class, which was only Hajimemashita, watashi wa Ana desu. Portugal kara kimashita. Watashi wa programa desu. Dozo yoroshiku ne. So that's only the things I learned. The rest is I try to add more. I'm not in the level where I can just add more sentences, I think. I'll try this exercise later. Anyways, so I'm taking the lessons via Skype twice a week and we get like word materials. So I'm going to show you. Oh, by the way, I try to do this to try and practice the katakana. And I'm also trying to learn in other ways. I wanted to say at the end, but you can print this out and try to write them down. But I don't know how much this helps, you know. At the end of the day, there's so many letters you have to memorize. I think using the mobile apps actually helps a lot, but you also need to practice writing and translating Japanese. So, you know, I think if you do that a lot, especially the translation, you will eventually get there. But yeah, I think it's a good idea if you are a person who like takes the bus or has waiting times, you should use the apps in those times. And also, it may be a good idea to print these and try to look at them over and over. This is just the alphabet, you know, the katakana and the hiragana. Maybe this helps for you. I mean, some people learn by listening, some people learn by speaking, some people learn by drawing, anyways, writing. But you gotta insist over and over and over, because of course, like our alphabet, like English alphabet for example, or Portuguese or French, it's about like 26 letters and that's it. That's all you have to memorize when it comes to symbols. But Japanese has like way, way, way more, because you have the hiragana, the katakana, and then you have the infinite kanji. So my cat is here, by the way. It looks like a pillow. Anyways, okay. So you have a lot to memorize, so don't be hard on yourself. I've been studying for a month and I have not memorized, like, maybe not even half of the symbols. There are some symbols that I can recall and a lot of them that I can't. So, you know, I have to keep going. I have to keep practicing over and over and over and over. Eventually, I will remember them, I assume. I'll tell you how that goes. Anyway, so we learned, like, classes, like, useful sentences to use in the class, I guess, and that we need to know. Aisatsu. Like greetings, sorry, I'm still not that healthy. So we have to repeat this randomly when the teacher decides. So it goes like this: Ohayou gozaimasu, good morning. Konnichiwa, good afternoon. Konbanwa, good evening. Genki desu ka, how are you? Genki desu, I'm alright. Sayonara, goodbye. Oyasumi nasai, good night. Mata ashita, so see you tomorrow. Mata atode, see you soon. Mata kondo, see you next time. Arigato gozaimasu, you know what this is. Sumimasen, which is like, can be thank you and can be like, excuse me, sorry. Domo, which is thank you also. Do itashimashite, which is you're welcome. Or ie, nandemo arimasen, it's also you're welcome. Gomenasai, that's sorry. Sumimasen, sorry. Mo. Moshiwake arimasen. Sorry again. Shitsureshimasu, which means excuse me. Onegaishimasu, please. We have to say this over and over. So this is Jugyo Yugo. So that's like class terms. Ajimemashou, which is let's begin. Owarimashou, let's end. Hi, yes. Yeah, no. No. Wakarimasu ka is do you understand? Wakarimashita ka, did you understand in the past? Hai, wakarimasu, yes I understand. Hai, wakarimashita, yes I understood. Ie, wakarimasen, no I don't understand. Daijoubu desu ka, are you okay? Hai, daijoubu desu, yes I'm okay. Ie, dame desu, no I'm not okay. Chotto mate kudasai, wait a bit. Moishido onegaishimasu, again please. This can be like nice if you are in Japan and somebody says something to you in Japanese. You can be like Moishido onegaishimasu, Moto yukuri onegaishimasu. You can also say this please speak slowly, like Moto yukuri onegaishimasu. Tenandesuka is like what is it. You can point at something. What tenandesuka? So yeah. So then we had exercises, henshu, so it's, henshu means exercises, where there's like sentences and we need to like choose what's the best like completion of the sentence, or you know, word that goes in the middle of the sentence. So yeah, this is a Jiko Shokai. So it's the presentation. Basically, we had to do our own presentation. So this is like the presentation, the exercise, we had to do our own. So like, I'm gonna read the Japanese like teacher example. So he wrote his presentation. So this is like, Hajimemashite, watashi wa Iwaoka desu. Nihon kara kimashita. Nihongo kyoshi desu. Dozo yoroshiku. So Nihongo kyoshi desu, it means like I'm a Japanese teacher. Teacher of Japanese. Yeah. So then we have to write our name in katakana. So basically, of course, I don't know how to write off my name out of like the blind out of my memory. I don't know. So I use these. Would you buy this if I sold these on Etsy? These are laminated. They are really strong. They don't get like dead with water. It's like a poster. So I use these to write my name in Japanese. Which you need to write your full name in Japanese. Start practicing that. Write your full name in Japanese every day or something. Because if you go to Japan, you're gonna have to write your name in Japanese a lot. Anyways, so then we learn the kozowado. Kozowado means like here, there, that. So I'm going to explain this better. Kore means this. Kono means like this also. Koko means here. Koshira means this person. Kochi means here as well. So you use the so for. Sore means that. Sono also kind of means that in English. In Portuguese, there's differences for all of these, like in Japanese, but I guess in English, this is only, it's always the same word. Soko is also like there. Sochira, that person. Sochi is like there as well. So, A, the kozowado. So, this we had the ko and we had the so. Now we're going to the a. Are, that. Ano, that. Ano, like that person. Azoko. Azoko, there. Achira, that person. Ano is not that person. Achira is. Ano is like that thing. Achi is there. Do. Dore? Wish. Wish. One wish. Dono is also wish or what. Dore is what or wish. And dono is wish. Doko is where. Dochira is where. And who? And wish. God. In English, this is like harder maybe. Dochi is where. Like in Portuguese, we actually have different words for all of these, just like in Japanese. But in English, I think a lot of these overlap. Then we have a few sentences. Kore wa nan desu ka? Then the answer. So this was the question. What is this? What is this? Kore wa nan desu ka? Then the person replies. Sore wa jisho desu. Dictionary. Jisho. So, sore wa jisho desu. So, like, the sentence goes like this. Kore wa nan desu ka? Sore wa jisho desu. Then we have a question about who is this book? Like, whose is this book? How do I say this? Kono hon wa dare no desu ka? Watashi no desu. Mine, it's my book. It's mine. The sentence only means it's mine. Watashi no desu. Toire wa doko desu ka? So this is a very good question for you if you travel to Japan. Like, where is the toilet? Toire wa doko desu ka? Azoko desu. So it's over there. Let me see. Okuni wa doshira desu ka? So this is like okuni, what country? Okuni, what country? Okuni wa doshira desu ka? Portugal desu. So this is pretty much that. If you want to ask where is the library, for example, Toshokan wa doko desu ka? Konwe no tonari desu. Konwe wo no tonari. Konwe no tonari desu. It means like it's on the next, like in the next place. Next. Okay, I cannot speak this. Where is the library? Toshokan wa doko desu ka? Konwe no tonari desu. Like it's on the side. That's what it means. Where is the library? It's on the side. So we had a bunch of exercises using these questions, like where is this, what is this. Then we have vocabulary. This is completely messy because I wrote all over it. So like we have, oh, useful word. I think that was here. Ticket. It was ticket somewhere. Anyways, koban. No, Kipu. Kipu is ticket, and Kipu Uriba is like the place where you buy the tickets. This may be useful if you go to Japan. Nek Tonari is next to. Achira is that one, that thing. Soko is here. Okay, we already seen this. Yubinkyo is the post office. Koba is the police. So we learned a bit of vocabulary. So Hidikashi no Naka. Naka is inside. Noshita. Izu no shita. I'm confused with my own notes. Hidikashi no. You have to learn the between, the under, and over something. You need to learn that. I'm confused with my own notes now. Noaida, I think it's below. Idikashi, I think, is a drawer. We learned so much random vocabulary, to be honest. Noto is like notebook. Megane, glasses, konbini, you know this. Ginko is like bank. Saifu is safe. Minato was harbor. Supermarket. Depato, department store. Yeah, that's just a lot. I'm very confused with my own notes here. Bazutei is like bus stop. Anyways, after a bit of vocabulary that I need to revise, we learned the numbers. Suji to jikan. We learned the numbers and the time. So a lot to memorize here as well. So first, it's easy because it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 1 to 10, you need to memorize this. After 1 to 10, it's easier because 11 is juichi, it's 10 and 11, 10 and 1. Because it's 10 and 2, 10 and 3, 10 and 4. And you use the same words. When you get to 20, you get to niju, and then it's like 2 and 10. So it's very easy to do the numbers. But then when you get to 100, you need to learn a new word, which is yaku. And then when you get to 1,000, the logic is always the same. When you get to 1,000, it's sen. When you get to 10,000, it's man, ichiman. And when you get to 100,000, it's juman. So the man, it's like no special word. Then you build for 100, then you have hyaku to say it's 100. You have sen to say it's like thousands. And then you have the sen when you have three, when you have... So, okay, sen is the thousands, and you have the man when you have four zeros, when it's 10,000. And I don't think there's anything after that, or I didn't learn after that. So, then after you know the numbers, then you have to know the time. It starts getting more complex when you get to the time. I learned before the time in German, stuff like that, and it was not that easy. Anyways, it's like... 1時, 2時, 3時, 4時, 5時, 6時, 7時, 8時, 9時, 10時. Then 11, 11時, 12時. So it's the same, but you add G at the end. It's the same as the regular numbers, but you add G at the end. And then the numbers go 1分. The numbers start to change between 分 and 分. So it's 1分, 2分, 3分, 4分, 5分. Ho-pun, nana-pun, nana-fun, ha-pun, kyu-fun, ji-pun. It's kind of weird to memorize, I guess, which one is the fun and which one is the pun. I don't know. You need to learn morning is gozen, afternoon is go-go, because they use AM and PM, so you need to say morning or afternoon. And then you have a word for midnight, heiji, a word for half an hour, so ha, it's ha. Then you have shodo, which is on point exactly. Shugo is minun, is noon. So then you have to like learn yesterday, before yesterday, today, tomorrow, and after tomorrow. As you can see, it gets more complicated. Like today is kyo, yesterday is kino. Before yesterday was ototoi. Tomorrow is ashita, and after tomorrow is azate. And I'm not gonna read all of these combinations because I'm tired, but saying like today is night, tomorrow night, yesterday is morning, before yesterday is afternoon, it gets a bit complex. You have to like practice quotes with that. Then we had exercises on that. I can say it gets more difficult. Then we had the moves, learning the dates. Ichigatsu, ni gatsu, san gatsu. It's always gatsu, so don't worry about that. It's the numbers with gatsu. The moves are easy, then the days are super hard. Day 1. Tsuitachi. You'd think that it's ichi something, day 1, but no, it's tsuitachi. Day 2 is futsuka. Day 3 is mika. Like, it makes no sense. The days are, like, super hard. Then you have the days of the week, which I also didn't memorize, which I don't think are easy either. So you have, like, Monday, getsuyobi, Tuesday, kayobi. Like, it's not easy to memorize. And I think we learned all of this already. And then we actually started learning even, like, the verbs. Last class, we started learning the verbs. God. Like how to make the past, how to make the present, how to make the future. The past is really easy because you add shita. So I have here the verb ikimasu, the verb iku. So like the verb is like ikimasu, and then in the past is like ikimashita, and then in the negative is ikimasen, negative past, ikimasen deshita. So. And yeah, we are now learning the verbs. It's really a lot of information, a lot of new things that you learn. I have a table of the verbs right here. So yeah, it's for sure a lot when you learn it the first time. But again, everything is, when you're learning something, everything is a lot in the beginning, and then it becomes easier. So I'm going to say what apps I use and what ways you can use to study now, because now that I went over the things that I learned already, I think the apps that are very useful to use every day is Drops. You can do a trick where you use Drops Japan and Drops Global into different email accounts, and you can do, instead of getting 5 minutes free a day, which is usually what they give you, you can get 10 minutes free a day. And trust me, it's worth it, because this is a visual app that shows you like the letter, and then you draw the letter, and it's the same for new words. They show you the word, they have an image that represents the word, and then you have to do exercises where you drag the correct word to the correct image. I think it's a very good app for you to get on every day and do very easy exercises where you have the sound, the image and the text, and everything is there to help you out. I think it's really good to do these Drops app every day. Then I do Duolingo also like every day, just an exercise or two. Duolingo is actually much better now than it was before. You can learn the symbols on one of the tabs. If you notice, there's a tab with a katakana symbol, and then you can touch, I think it's no. Anyways, you can touch that and check and do exercises. But you can also do the full sentences on the like regular standard mode of Duolingo. Actually, it's pretty useful. Then you can learn Hey Japan and Lingo Deer. Hey Japan and Lingo Deer are actually really good. Hey Japan is really good for making sentences, understanding what's the rules of the sentences. And Lingo Deer is very good to actually memorize the how to write the letters, how to really, and it's good for vocabulary, but also very good to learn how to write and read Japanese. I think Lingo Deer is really good for that. So those are the apps I recommend. I also recommend you just consume stuff in Japanese. Like, for example, sometimes I go on Netflix and I watch a series in Japanese. They have English subtitles in the like subtitles. And I try to recognize words. I try to pay attention to the audio. The other day I was watching Terrace House, and the girl, like, it was Christmas and the girl got a gift and it was a pencil. And I heard Empitsu and I was like, oh my god, I just learned what Empitsu is in my classes. So try to, like, hear the Japanese and see what words you recognize and what sentences. Yeah, and eventually when you're good enough with reading and writing, you can try to, like, change the subs to Japanese. But that's in a higher level. In the beginning, I think that's too hard. Just try to, like, learn vocabulary, learn sentences, and start writing very easy things, like write Ohio, write your name, write hello, good morning, write yes, no, hi, yeah, write like coffee, write like very easy things in the beginning. My voice is giving, I cannot speak anymore. This is kept. This is pretty much all I have to say for now. I'll do like a video as I go and learn more stuff, and I do different exercises and all that, and I'll share them with you. Eventually I want to get to a level where I try to make videos speaking Japanese. We'll see about that. Having the title in Japanese, the thumbnail in Japanese, speaking Japanese, and maybe I add the English translation in the video itself. I think that would be so cool. That's definitely a goal for me. But anyways, thank you so much for watching, and please subscribe, please leave a like, support the channel. We are almost at 900 subs, please. Bye bye, matane.